What's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. So in this video, I wanted to talk to you guys about a topic. I think a topic that we should all talk about, and it's a topic I thought about a few weeks ago, but I got sidetracked. And recently, I obviously watched Thick Whip's new video, and it kind of reminded me of this topic. And some things that you should look into when you're purchasing a car or purchasing any car, not even just a BMW, but these are some things that you should take into account when you're purchasing a used vehicle. So when you're purchasing a used BMW or any used car in general, just know if it's a sports car or something in the realm of, if somebody would mod it, they're gonna mod it. Just know that all, maybe about 75% of the BMWs out there that probably you're looking into has been modified one way or the other, whether it's suspension, exhaust, tunes, and that's something that you should automatically already take into account. Doesn't mean that you won't find a car that's bone stock, that's never been molested or modified. And when you're purchasing a car and you're thinking and you're going into it thinking that it's not modified and it's bone stock, when you start driving it through a long period of time, you may have an issue. And that issue may be that the car is on the wrong tune. Sometimes when people part out their cars, they may take all the supporting mods out, like downpipes, exhaust, intakes, fuel systems, but they won't tune it back to the stock map, and they're just clear codes. And that's something that you should probably look into when purchasing a used vehicle. And I'll tell you guys later on some things you could look into on how you can find out if the car's been tuned or if the car's been modified. So I just wanted to mention that if you're purchasing an F8X, just know 75%, if not more, are modified. Whether it's an exhaust, suspension, a tune, turbos, you name it, about 75% of the cars out there are modified. This doesn't have to be only F8X, it could be any other platform that has a big supporting modification community, like a Subaru, like the WRX STIs, even like the F10 M5s, F90s, and it goes on and on, right? But you also have to take into account when you are purchasing these types of vehicles that a good amount of them are going to be modded. And one telltale sign by looking at the appearance of the car, when you first look at it, if it's been modified, stock parts are missing, that's something you can see. But there's also some things you can't see, like downpipes, unless you put it up on a lift. Even if you go to a dealership or a used car dealership, they're going to tell you exactly what you want to hear, right? They're going to tell you exactly what you want to hear, but there's certain ways around it. So we'll get into that later on. But I also wanted to mention, this is something that is not a fail-safe. It's something that you should probably do anyway, but find a reputable company that's going to do a pre-purchase inspection, also known as PPI. So pre-purchase inspection, what it is that you pay a company that's reputable, whether it's a performance shop or whether a company that just does that in general. What they do is they take the vehicle that you're looking into buying, they inspect it, and they inspect every single thing, whether it's from the brakes, tires, the paint, any imperfections, and it goes on and on. But it also depends on which company you're looking into. Some companies may be able to go more in depth, and then some companies are not going to go in depth, but you pay for what you get for, right? So if you're paying a little bit more to get a PPI and they're doing a lot more, I would pay a little bit more to do that, because in the long run, it's going to save you money. Obviously, if you don't want to pay the extra dollars, $100, $200 for that extra resource, you should definitely look into that, because in the long run, it may save you a headache. So I also mentioned that it's not a fail-safe. So there's also things where they could hide, whether it's a tune and things like that, check engine lights. Recently, a buddy of mine was looking for an E9X, and he was looking for a Melbourne Red, which is really rare to find for E9X, and he found one. It looked immaculate on photos, but when he did a PPI on it, it came up so many red flags, like the bottom was all scraped up, it looked like the car was slammed before it was put back on stock suspension, and also it had check engine lights that was already cleared. So that's something that will pop up and kind of get you thinking too. And a good example too with that, pre-purchase inspection, a check engine light came up with a Vanos. And if you guys know about Vanos, it could be anything from something small to something big on that E9X platform. But he decided to pass on that because he didn't want to deal with the unknown headaches, because there's a lot of things that the seller wasn't disclosing. So those are the things that you should look into. But going back into whether the car has been tuned or not. So one thing you should look into about the car has been tuned is that So when you purchase a car and unknowingly it has a tune on it and you're driving it, and the car is not made up for that setup, meaning that it's not having the supporting mods, whether it's the fuel ratios, the downpipes, air to fuel ratio, everything's all mixed up. So what it's going to be doing is putting more strain on the motor and other components of the car, whether it's a turbo motor, and a whole bunch of other things which you don't want happening. So that's definitely one thing that's the unknown about purchasing a used car. I don't want to get you scared about it. I don't want you to get scared about purchasing a used car, but these are some tips that you could look into when you're going into that process, because I know you're so excited. I know when I was looking for a car, I was so excited, but good thing I bought this car from the dealership, and technically it was owned by the dealership and nobody else owned it, but it had a few thousand miles on it. So I was lucky to be able to get a stock car that's never been modded and never been molested, to be honest. So I'm really happy for that. But nowadays, when you're looking for an F8X, you're not gonna find that. It's gonna be a little bit more rare, but when you do, you're gonna be paying a little bit more premium, because it is, end of the day, probably gonna be worth it. So additionally too, when you let's say you already purchased the car, right? What you can do too is go to a local performance shop that deals with tunes, whether it's Boot Mod, DME, MHD, where they could look up the car and see if the car has been tuned or if there's a current map on it. And that would tell you exactly what you need to do or what you need to take off. And here's the worst case scenario. Let's just say you bought a car, you know, sight unseen, it came on the trailer, you see it, it looks immaculate on the outside, and you drive it. But the car is feeling a little bit weird. You're putting 93 octane in it, just thinking that because it is a turbo vehicle, you're gonna need to put 93 octane. But lo and behold, the car really needs E85. So those are the things you need to look into exactly, because that in the long run is gonna mess up your motor, it's gonna mess up your pockets. And one thing I mention all the time too is using the forums. The forums is a good resource in reference to learning about the car and also and researching about the previous owner too. So a lot of times I've seen on the forums, on either the F30 forums or even the F8X forums, is that people have posted like, hey, have you guys seen this car before, or do you know who the owner is? And they'll show the listing either on Craigslist or even on cars.com, whatever search engine they're using, they'll post it up. And sometimes people are actually able to give insight because it has a distinctive wheels, modifications that, you know, it like, oh, that's my buddy's car. He sold it to the dealership. Now it's being sold at the dealership. But yeah, it's been this, this, and this. So those are things that you should definitely, you know, use your intuition about and take the time to actually research before you buy. So here's one thing that I always do when I look at a car is check the body panels. If the body panels are not lining up correctly, if there's more orange peel than the other body panel, then it should bring up a red flag. Well, obviously this is all done and you can see it done when you do a PPI, the pre-purchase inspection, or if you're going to see it yourself, visually inspect it, look at the door panels, if they're lining up, the seams of it, right, on the side edges, those things they should look into. And also, if it's been resprayed, unless it's a really, really good paint job, it's never gonna be 100%. So when I mean it's never gonna be 100% is that a good painter is gonna be able to match the orange peel to the other panels. Because if you guys don't know what orange peel is, it's basically how the paint settles onto the body panels, and it's never gonna be 100% smooth. You'll be able to see like a distinct pattern, but that distinct pattern should be all across the vehicle. So if there's something that stands out where it's like it's different than the other, then that's something you should bring up to the person you're buying it from, or even the dealership you're buying it from. Because a lot of times when you purchase a vehicle, if people get into accidents, whether it's a minor fender bender or something that they did themselves and they don't want it to show up on the Carfax, what they're gonna do is probably get it fixed on their own so it doesn't come up. Because in the long term, they're thinking in their mind is that if I show insurance that I've been in an accident or I have damage, it's gonna take a hit on the value of the car. So a lot of people won't do that to save in the long term. But that's something that you should definitely look into by really inspecting it. Take your time, there's no reason to rush a purchase, especially when the car is used. And then going back into the PPI, what the person that's inspecting it or the company that's inspecting it, they could tell you if some bolts have been changed, because you'll be able to see markings on the bolts, right? Whether it's suspension bolts or exhaust bolts that's holding the exhaust in place. And you'll be able to see exactly that this factory bolt has been touched, and the person that you're getting the PPI done from, they'll be able to tell you exactly if it's done like that. But in the long term, suspension and exhaust really doesn't really do too much of a nuisance to your car. And one thing you could do too is, if you're buying, let's say, a BMW or F80, you could also contact the buyer or even a dealership if they could give you the service records. And a lot of times when you buy these newer BMWs, a lot of times you're able to get the service records because they require you, and they kind of give you, like, I know back in the day, maintenance was not 100% covered under the car, but a lot of these new, policies from companies and major manufacturers, they're giving you like 3 years free maintenance, and a lot of those service records stay with them. And sometimes too, people will actually just continue going to the dealership to get their service done, whether it's oil changes, warranty claims, and just service in general. And then if you're thinking like, hey, this car is paying more of a premium, but the person has all the service records, has all documentation, and the car is immaculate, in these days, in this market right now, you're going to be paying the premium. And you're going to be paying the premium just to get a better, I guess, peace of mind. Because in the long term, it's just going to save you headaches. And then when you buy a car that's going to cause you these headaches, you're never going to want to do it again. So now that we got over to some of the things that I want to talk to you guys about, what to look for, some things that you should do when you first get a car, when you first purchase the car, is I highly recommend getting paint protection film. Paint protection film is going to be film that's clear, that's a little bit more durable. It's going to go onto the paint of the car. It's going to provide you extra more protection. In the front clip of my car here, the whole front clip actually has paint protection film. Whether it's the bumper, headlights, the hood, the quarter panels, and also my mirror covers. Because if you really think about it, when this is going down the highway and you're just driving the highway in general, there's always debris, sand, rocks that gets kicked up from the vehicles ahead of you. And also too, I noticed this first when I first met Miguel and a whole bunch of other guys when we did a rally up to Orlando, is that, thank God I had PPF, is that the guys that have PS4s, Michelin PS4s, they're extremely, extremely sticky and they kick up so many rocks. So going back into it, is paint protection necessary? If you are, I guess, OCD and you want to preserve your paint, because I had a white car and I never got paint protection film because I had no idea what it was. Even back in the day, it was F30, and when I sold the car, the whole front was pitted. And what I mean pitted was that there was microscopic and also bigger rock chips all around the front, and it never made the bumper look smooth. And you could see it, especially on a white car, you could definitely see it, because behind the paint is black plastic. Even if it's gone through the primer. That's the first thing I did when I bought this car, is paint protection film for the front clip. And like I said, that includes the hood, the front bumper, the quarter panels in the front, and also did the mirror covers along with the headlights. Like I said, is it necessary to do the whole car? It depends on you. You know, if you have a car that's, you consider a collector, whether it's a nice classic or it's a unique color, then maybe. Some people don't like it because you don't really get to touch the real paint anymore. But to be honest, with the paint protection film, which I'll do a video later down the road, maybe my next car, about the whole paint protection film, is that the paint protection film, a lot of these companies right now are making it very hydrophobic. So hydrophobic means when the water, I guess, dissipates off the surface of the material. And I can tell you this, I have SunTech PPF in the front of the car, and it's extremely hydrophobic, especially when I put additional protectant on it. The water just rushes off the paint protection film compared to the rest of the car, because I've never gotten the car ceramic coated, because I like testing different products. That's just my thing. I love using different products in the car. And if you guys see my car in person and also on photos, I'm telling you, this car is immaculate. I'm talking about the paint is spotless. You might have some like very faint micro scratches, and I'm talking about very faint. It's not that bad, but we'll see. I will get a ceramic coat, maybe I will get it polished, but like I said, it doesn't need it now. But going back into the paint protection film, if your car is, like I said, very unique color, maybe do it. I know for me, it's more of a peace of mind that you're not scratching the paint. Then again, also too, is that you're not touching the paint anymore. You're touching basically plastic. So I do want to wrap this video up. I do want to mention that I'm so happy that John Thick Whips was able to find a new motor for his unfortunate situation. And I'm a found believer that everything happens for a reason, especially when a situation like that where you're thinking your motor just blew and it's gonna be thousands of dollars. And he says in his video he's taking a big hit on that, but in the long term, you gotta watch that video. The recent video he did actually today on Saturday, he has an incredible deal, and it's all from the guys from Straight Six Auto Parts. I think they're out in California, so big shout out to them for getting him the new motor, because he's gonna be dropping that motor in and getting ready for the invasion of Orlando. So excited to actually meet John and the rest of the guys from the whole community, because I really think the BMW community is probably one of the best communities out there. And I said it multiple times before, because we look out for each other, whether we troll or not, but we really look out for each other. So that's why I'm so happy to make these videos for you guys. And a lot of you guys give me the positive feedback, and a lot of you guys are giving the feedback where it keeps me motivated. So thank you so much. So I want to thank you guys so much for watching. And again, you know, if you guys watch this video and you guys find it helpful in any way, or you guys find it entertaining, hit the thumbs up. It really helps my small channel grow. And also, if you guys have any tips or tricks about purchasing a used vehicle or anything that I left out, or if you need any clarification, let me know in the comments. And also, for the people that have any other tricks, is that, you know, in hindsight, people are going to read the comments and they're going to take your advice, and it may save them the headache. So like I said, this is the best community out there, and I want to thank you guys again for watching. But other than that, I'll see you guys next week. So peace.